Hello. Greetings.
Greetings to you. Great to have you here. Congrats on everything. That cover of Highway to Hell is the album's first single, and I believe that your version of the song has its origins here in Australia. Is that right?
It certainly does. I was playing with the E Street Band in 2014 in Perth, the home of Bon Scott, the original singer of AC/DC, of course, and I went to go pay my respects to his grave late one night. I found myself later in the hotel bar and suggested to Bruce Springsteen that there might be the possibility that the world of AC/DC and the world of the E Street Band might overlap in some capacity. He suggested we start practicing Highway to Hell over the course of the next couple of sound checks. We found ourselves in a Melbourne football stadium with 60, 70, 80,000 people a few days later, and Eddie Vedder happened to be in town on a solo tour of his own. I knocked on Bruce's dressing room door and said, "We are in Australia, where AC/DC is king and where the song Highway to Hell is the unofficial national anthem of rock and roll liberalism. What if we opened the show with Highway to Hell with Eddie Vedder singing?" And we did, and it was an apex moment in the history of live rock and roll music. And so as I was finishing up this new record of mine, the Atlas Underground Fire, I thought what a great capstone it would be for the record to try to capture that lightning that we had on stage in Melbourne on this album with Highway to Hell. Two of the greatest rock and roll singers of all time, Bruce Springsteen and Eddie Vedder, singing one of the greatest rock and roll songs of all time.
Yeah, only Tom Morello, Eddie Vedder and Bruce Springsteen. What, was Axl Rose not available? What's going on?
We didn't want too much of a good thing, you know what I mean? Like,
well, you've said that Kanye West has inspired you as well. How did he inspire you?
In a roundabout way. I have a nice studio at my house, but I don't know how to work it. There's normally an engineer there. So during lockdown time, there was no engineer coming. So there I was, you know, it was this period like kind of musical drought. But I read an article where Kanye was bragging about recording the vocals to a couple of his hit albums onto the voice memo of his iPhone. And I thought, well, if it's good enough for Kanye's vocals on hit albums, then maybe it's good enough for my electric guitar. So I just set the phone on a chair in front of my amp and cranking out riffs and then sending them to producers, engineers, and artists all around the world. And that really kind of, the floodgates then opened. And I realized that I could be creative during this time when it seemed like it was not going to be the case.
It's so great to hear, because none of us know how to work our state-of-the-art home studios either.
Well, there's a lesson there for all. If you've got your iPhone, then you, Kanye West, and Tom are all on absolute equal artistic footing.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. You've solved a problem for everybody, I think. You mentioned the guitar riffs that you were playing into your phone. Promise me this album is full of signature meaty Tom Morello riffs.
It's a ironclad guarantee. One of the reasons why I made this record, The Atlas Underground Fire, was to, like, I'm a firm believer that the electric guitar is the greatest instrument ever invented by humankind, from subtle nuance to stadium destruction. But I also believe that it's an instrument that has a future and not just a past. You know, and that's why kind of wending my way through these various genres of hard rock and EDM and spooky electronica, you know, there's plenty of red meat on the bone Morellian riffs, do not fear.
You are, if nothing else, one of the most innovative guitar players, one of the greats of modern guitar playing. Is it true that you used to try to mimic things like animal sounds and stuff like that on the guitar?
Yeah, I think that when one picks up an instrument, there are sort of two categories you can wind up in. You can be a musician, or you can be an artist. And for the first 10 years of my playing, I became a very technically talented musician, but I didn't have my own voice on the instrument or really anything to say. It was around the beginnings of Rage Against the Machine when I started self-identifying as the DJ in the band. I began sort of assembling this vocabulary by rather than imitating Chuck Berry and Eddie Van Halen solos, I started imitating helicopter noises and buffalo at the zoo and R2-D2 sounds. And that's what I was practicing 8 hours a day. And now you may not be able to accurately play helicopter noises, buffalo sounds at the zoo, and R2-D2 noises, but if you practice that stuff 8 hours a day, you do not sound like Chuck Berry or Eddie Van Halen. And that was like the sonic vocabulary I started to create that has been what I've been writing in over the course of the 20 records now.
Rage Against the Machine's much-anticipated reunion tour that everyone was so excited about was postponed due to the pandemic. Is it going to happen?
I'm a big fan of the joy and the celebration of live rock and roll music, but I want it to be, you know, somewhere where the fans and the band and the crew are all safe. You know, you want to have a great time, but I don't want to sort of feel sort of an additional burden of extending the plague because of people in the those mosh pits tend to be a lot of people like coughing in one another's mouths. So I just want to make sure that everybody's cool.
Well, we can't wait to see you in Australia. There is a bar in Perth waiting for you and Springsteen to come back and plan some more greatness.
All right, I can't wait to be some of my just a personal like thanks to all the friends, fans, and comrades over the course of three decades. Some of my favorite moments of live music, from club shows to stadium shows to experiences, you know, in the Cherry Bar on AC/DC Lane, have been on, you know, touring in Australia. So I just want to say thank you to everybody all that time for being a part, whether you're a new member to the journey or someone who's been around for a long time. A sincere and heartfelt thanks, and can't wait to see you in the pit again, hopefully sometime in the not too distant future.
Hear, hear. Well, your new album, The Atlas Underground Fire, is out this Friday, October 15th. It's always a pleasure. Tom, thank you so much.
Thanks so much for having me. Hope we'll see you later. Cheers, everybody. Peace.
What a great video, and we've got plenty more, so why not click the subscribe button here? Or is it here? Or is it... Sorry, I can't see the button. I'm not wearing my glasses. But you can see it, so you click on it to make sure you don't miss any more content.